This scene right here.
I'm not yours.
Mm.
You know you're wrong about that. She is my mother.
Your mom? You crazy? Your mom's maggot food.
My mom said she'd always be with me. She chose your mom as a way of coming back.
Hey, Mark. Don't f*** me.
Alright, so Patrick C.C. literally just dropped a video from Home Alone to the life of, how do you say his name? Macaulay Culkin? That's how you say his name? I've heard stuff about him. I'm not gonna lie. I heard he did drugs. You can clearly tell, bro. Look at his face.
Home Alone has been a Christmas classic for Americans. Macaulay Culkin, who plays the role of Kevin, has entertained generations of families, always keeping the Christmas spirit alive. However, despite the massive success at such a young age, Macaulay never wanted this life. Being an actor was his father's dream that he forced upon his seven children. Macaulay just ended up being the most successful. Before age 13, he was fed up and wanted away from the spotlight. This was the catalyst that led to one of the most tragic.
Like, bro, look at, like, it just screams, I do drugs. Hold on. He just screams, I do drugs. I do everything. Cocaine, I'm here for it.
That led to one of the most tragic downfalls Hollywood has seen in regards to child stars. Drugs, arrests,
is that
public
spit?
Ridicule,
oh my God, bro.
Strange relationship with Michael Jackson. This is the story of Macaulay Culkin, the life he never wanted. Macaulay's parents, Kit and Patricia, had seven children. Shane, Dakota, Macaulay, Kieran, Quinn, Christian, and Rory. The Culkins had a rough upbringing, to say the least. They lived in a railroad apartment in a tenement on East 94th Street and 2nd Avenue in New York City. The home was barely suitable for a couple. It was just a hallway with no separating doors except for the bathroom, which didn't even have a lock. It was not an ideal environment for children, but they kept having more babies. Macaulay, who also goes by Mac, began acting at age 4, appearing in roles on stage, on television, and in films throughout the 80s. He landed some pretty big hits, like Rocket Gibraltar and Uncle Buck. But Mac didn't exactly land those roles because of an inherent passion for acting. His father's dream was for his children to star in films, because he was a dancer slash actor whose career was cut short. The peak of Kit Culkin's career was being an extra on the Broadway play West Side Story in 1961 and another small role in Hamlet in 1964. He had never experienced any sort of true fame or main character spotlight that he so longed for. His career was cut short over a small incident that he could not get past.
So, doing King Lear, off Broadway.
Right.
He's playing Gloucester.
Way off
Broadway. He's playing Gloucester, and Gloucester gets his eyes poked out.
Yeah.
So, he is so into his part, he closes his eyes. And so he's doing the soliloquy, and he's getting closer and closer to the edge of the stage.
Yeah.
And he doesn't notice because he's so into the part, because he's blind. Yeah. And then he spills into the first row.
Yeah.
And hurts himself. This is opening night.
Yeah.
And injures himself and can't do the rest of the run of the whole show.
Uh-huh.
And apparently that was like the last acting gig he ever did, because it was quite embarrassing.
Since Kit could not deal with the shame and embarrassment, he pushed his dream onto his children, starting with his firstborn son.
It's interesting how parents do that, and like they don't think for a second, do my kid, or like, is this what my kid wants? Does my kid really want to be an actor? Do my kid really want to go to college, be a doctor, be a lawyer? That's kind of why kids, like, I guess, lash out in some cases, where like they kind of do things out of the blue, out of the normal. It's because they're being forced to do something that they don't want to do, and therefore they can't be who they want to be. They can't pursue what they want to do because their future is literally in their parents' hands and they have no say-so. This is why kids lash out, and this is probably why he did heroin. Like, it's all making sense. So if it is, then I'm not surprised.
Shane was supposed to be the actor slash dancer that his father never was, so they just kind of brought Macaulay along with them to ballet classes, theater, and movie auditions. Mac says that he was an afterthought. His brother Kieran also felt the same way. My parents were running a little theater, the Light Opera of Manhattan, and whenever a production needed a kid, they were like, what age and what gender? We've got 7 of them right over here. Kieran felt that they were often used as onstage props. But to his father's surprise, Macaulay was a superior dancer, and producers were much more interested in him than Shane.
He was daring, and if you can say a 6-year-old is daring, he just wasn't afraid to do anything. I mean, he'd do whatever you asked and more.
Which led him to getting booked for almost every role he auditioned for. Once he landed Uncle Buck, which generated $67 million in the box office, the family's finances began to rely on what Mac was earning. Although Kit didn't see what everyone else saw in Macaulay, he knew Mac was his ticket to Hollywood, leading them to a role that was about to change their family's life forever. After a hectic start to a family trip to Europe, writer and producer John Hughes conceptualized the idea of Home Alone. While preparing for vacation, he wrote down a list of everything he didn't want to forget, and jokingly added his children to that list. At that moment, he thought, what if I left my 10-year-old son at home? What would he do? One what if led to another, and while taking a break from packing, Hughes wrote 8 pages of notes that later developed into the screenplay of Home Alone. Since he previously worked on Uncle Buck with Macaulay, Hughes wrote the Home Alone script specifically for him to play the role as Kevin McAllister. Macaulay's blockbuster film, Home Alone, was released in November.
I'm not gonna lie, I think Home Alone is kind of overhyped. This is just my personal opinion, you know? It is a good movie, but it's overhyped from what people make it to be. Like, yeah, it's funny, but like, bro, it's not having me in tears. Well, it could be because now that I'm older, so like my humor changed, but maybe growing up I did enjoy it a little bit more, but looking at it now, yeah, it wasn't really all that.
For 1990 and became the 3rd highest grossing film of all time worldwide, behind E.T. and the Star Wars films. It earned nearly $500 million in worldwide box office. Its huge success even gave rise to a Hollywood phrase. To be home alone meant having your own movie's box office dwarfed by another wildly popular film. Macaulay basically became an A-list celebrity overnight.
I mean, this is it, pal. You are a bona fide star as of right now. The number one box office movie of the weekend. Nice to have you on the show.
Okay.
In that first interview, it kind of seems like he isn't really fazed about the success of the film. And although he could be nervous, he probably didn't care, because this was all just a basic routine for him.
Did you have any say in whether or not you worked when you were young?
Not really, no.
Yeah.
Like, it was, after a while, it became, like I said, a job, and it was, I never chose the projects. They were, like, my parents, right. Like, you know, essentially, like, chose them for me.
So they so were, it was like, kind of good news, Macaulay.
Yeah, exactly. You know, yeah. Yeah, they called
you're
me Macaulay.
You're
going
to buy us a new house.
yeah, there you go, you know. And, like, I never read any of the scripts. Like, wow. I would just read, like, the lines for, like, the next day or whatever. Like, I would, like, get the gist of what the movie was about, but then I just kind of show up and hit my marks, find my light, and recite my lines, you know.
So surreal.
Yeah.
It's kind of just like, again, like, it's what you do.
Right.
Like, it's like in the same way that, like, yeah, like, kids go to, like, school or something like that. Like, you know, you fall into a routine to a certain extent.
No choice in whether or not he was allowed
That's
to
wild.
Act. No choice in what roles he could play.
I love this movie. My girl. Talking about my girl. Great movie, sad moment for this guy. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but if you haven't seen it, it does strike a tear. So I think they have it on Netflix if you guys wanna like check it out. It's a good movie. I think they did make a My Girl too. That one was alright. But this one, yeah, it definitely had me teary-eyed.
Barely was even prompted about his roles. Macaulay was essentially just being told what to do and moving like a robot. This is where the tension between Macaulay and his father worsened. The Culkin family was not yet rich. Mac was only paid $100,000 for Home Alone, so his father
knew
he needed to capitalize on the momentum for them to make some huge money. He immediately negotiated his next film, My Girl, in which Macaulay got paid $1.5 million. At the time, child labor laws allowed the child...
Oh my god! What is this? The Good Son. Let me show you guys this one scene.
I didn't mean to cause any trouble.
This scene was like...
It's not your fault,
wait,
Henry.
Is this it right here?
Mark is going
Let's
through
fast forward.
Therapy. What did you tell her? Sorry? It's strictly confidential. But you better stop telling lies about me. Because no one's going to believe you.
Sooner or later, they're going to find out about you.
Who's they?
It's a great
Dad?
Movie. You guys should watch it.
My mom?
I told your mom.
Why would she believe you? She's my mom, not yours.
Mm.
You know you're wrong about that. She is my mother.
Your mom? You crazy? Your mom's maggot food.
My mom said she'd always be with me. She chose your mom as a way of coming back. But I guess you wouldn't understand that. But it's true. She's my mother now.
Hey, Mark. Don't fuck with me.
This is such a good movie. You guys have to watch it, bro. You guys have to watch it. I don't think this is on... This was on Netflix, like, years ago. But, like, I think you can find this on, like, maybe HBO Max or, like, Prime Video. This movie was so good. That... Bro, he played this role amazing. Psychopath.
...filed to work for 10 hours per day, but a parent or legal guardian needed to supervise them for the entire time. This essentially takes Kit out of the workforce, giving him no choice but to take a cut of Mac's income. Plus, they had to travel outside of New York for films. Macaulay says that although he spent a lot of time with his father, they were never close.
I don't blame him.
Disliked him all through it.
Yeah, and he disliked me too. Like, we didn't like each other.
Really?
Yeah. But then all of a sudden, imagine this now, this man who you dislike, kind of thing, and he dislikes you. Now I become the sole, like, focus of him when I start earning. So now all of a sudden I'm, like, you know, going around the country, like, locked in a room with a guy who doesn't like me, kind of thing. But at the same time, like, yeah, it's...
But
know,
how does that... Why?
I was kind of even, like, relatively jealous, you know?
Sure. Oh, he was jealous.
I think so. I everything...
Of course he was jealous. His career fell down, so now he's trying to live that through you. He's seeing you doing this and that, earning a money. Of course he's going to feel a certain way. He's doing something he could never keep going. His life sucks, man. His life sucks. Oh my gosh. Having no say in what you want to do, but yet your father, pretty much your manager, signing you up for this casting, that casting, probably commercials, and you're just going with it because you think it's just part of your everyday life. When does it end? We're going to find out.
That he tried to do in his life, like, I excelled at, like, before I was 10 years old. He was a bad man. Like, honestly, he was a bad man. He was abusive and, like, yeah, like, physically and mentally, like, yeah.
As if it couldn't get any worse, he also had to deal with the repercussions of fame. There would be times when Macaulay walked down the street only to be crowded by hordes of people.
One time I wore a ski mask and goes, I was walking down the street, you know, this guy goes, you know, I heard him just whispering, is that the kid from Wobble? I'm like, wearing a ski mask, boy. No, I better get my plans. I better get a facelift or something, you know.
One time, Mac pulled a hat low over his forehead in attempt to look anonymous. A woman walked up, grabbed the cap off his head, peered at him, and said, yeah, it's him. And
wow.
Then, you're not that cute. Mac couldn't hide.
Who are you? Who are you? You're not that cute? Man, I would have said, but you watching all my movies, though. Fuck off. That's what I would have said, bro. At that moment, like, I could talk shit because I know you got my DVD on your TV stand. Like, you're running towards me, trying to get my autograph, trying to get a picture, maybe. You're not that cute. Bet your daughter thinks I'm cute. How about that?
His success, but none of his siblings could truly understand what he felt. But there was one person that could relate to Macaulay, and that man was Michael Jackson. Like Kit Culkin, Michael's father, Joe Jackson, initiated a plan to get his family out of poverty and into superstardom. Joe trained his children to dance and sing. If they made a mistake during rehearsals, he would beat them with the buckle end of a belt, an electrical cord, or a tree branch. More specifically, their father targeted Michael, maliciously teasing his appearance and breaking down his self-confidence. Macaulay and Michael lived a childhood where their fathers despised them, despite needing them to provide for their family financially. Michael was quite literally the only person Mac could relate
to. Hold on, phone call.
But there was one obviously weird thing about this relationship. Michael was 33 years old, and Macaulay was 10. Over the years, Michael had befriended multiple children, inviting them and their families to his infamous Neverland Ranch, a full-blown amusement park at his estate. He hung out with these children and occasionally had sleepovers.
Is this where the rumor started? Is this where the rumor came about? Michael loves children?
Culkin's parents were fine with the friendship. Macaulay and Kieran visited Neverland Ranch often. Macaulay even says that he slept in Michael's bed about 10 times.
What happened at the house? That's what all these things that people are concerned about.
That's what's
about.
So weird, you know.
What did happen?
Nothing happened, you know. Nothing, really. I mean, we played video games, you know. We played
sleep
it as an amusement
bed.
Park. Well, the thing is with that whole thing is that, you know, they go, oh, you slept in the same bedroom as him. It's like, I don't think you understand. Michael Jackson's bedroom is two stories.
And
it has like three bathrooms and this and that. So when I slept in his bedroom, yeah, but you have to understand the whole scenario. And the thing is with Michael.
Through all the ups and downs in Michael's life, Mac was there for him. Mac never publicly bashed him. He only has positive memories of the star. In 2005, he testified under oath that all accusations of sexual misconduct were absolutely ridiculous and untrue. Home Alone 2, Lost in New York, was the 1992 sequel to Home Alone that was another smash hit. Mac was paid $4 million for the film, and it earned more than $359 million in the box office. It was met with some criticism initially for having basically the same exact plot as the first one, with some minor tweaks. But over the years, this film has become the most iconic and beloved of the series. The monstrous success leveled up the Culkins immensely. Macaulay was officially the most successful and highest paid child in Hollywood since Shirley Temple. And still to this day, I don't think there's a more iconic child star than Macaulay Culkin. His father, Kit, gained substantial influence in Hollywood, because for studio executives to reach Macaulay, they needed to go through Kit. In 1993, Premiere magazine rated Kit Culkin the 48th most powerful person in Hollywood, ahead of Michael Douglas and Eddie Murphy. Studio executives complained that Kit tried to use his power to seize creative control of Macaulay's movies. Because of this controlling nature, Kit was making enemies quickly. Little did they know that Macaulay Culkin's career at age 12 just peaked, and it was all downhill from here. The Good Son was a thriller where Mac plays the role
movie.
Of Henry, a psychopathic child who kills people. The film did $60 million in the worldwide box office, which seems like a massive step down since Home Alone, but considering a totally different movie genre and not based on Christmas, I would say it's still good numbers. Mac was still beloved for his acting, and most of the negative reception was based on the plot. By 1993, Macaulay was just tired and desperately told his father he needed a break. He just wanted to go to school. He said, "Yeah, sure." And the next thing I knew, I was on the next set doing the next thing, and it just kind of clicked in my brain. Okay, there's basically nothing I can do to make this stop. I was making God knows how much.
What do you go to? Like, where was his mom in this whole thing? What was his mom saying? What was his mom doing? I mean, she was getting abused, so it's like she probably couldn't say or do anything to like stop him. That's a tough childhood.
Much money, and Kit was making me sleep on the couch just because he could, just to let you know who's in charge, and just to let you know if he doesn't want you to sleep in a bed, you're not going to sleep in a bed. The Nutcracker, Getting Even with Dad, The Pagemaster, Richie Rich. These next four movies all released in 1994, and evidently, the world was sick of Macaulay Culkin. He was cashing in an $8 million salary for each film, which is equivalent to about $16.5 million in 2023 value. Richie Rich was the only decently successful movie at a $75 million worldwide box office, and that's because it's basically the same format as Home Alone. It became increasingly clear that Macaulay failed to find substantial success outside of Home Alone.
And then my father and my mother finally, you know, called it quits, which was one of the best things that ever happened.
Imagine celebrating your parents' divorce. That's hilarious.
I was able to actually, like, walk away from the business. I've been wanting to take a break for a while, and eventually, like, I just was like, I'm done. I'm done, guys. Like, I hope you all made your money, because there's no more coming from me, and it's, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
So, now, but, like, I guess.
I quit for, like, 8 years. I mean,
At the moment, this was the greatest thing that happened to Mac, but it was the straw that broke the camel's back in his parents' marriage. They were gearing up for a divorce and a very public battle for custody over him. He did not want to go with his father, but his mother was spending all of her money on lawyers trying to fight him. So the only way Mac could get access to his money was to legally take both of his parents' names off of his trust fund. He found an executor to protect and look over his finances, and was able to secure his multi-million dollar fortune. Kit never showed up for the last day of the trial. He stole all of Mac's memorabilia, and he hasn't seen him since the mid-90s. It was never about money for Kit. It was about control. Once he lost control, he disappeared, and he brought the ship down with him. New York Magazine noted that his rapid ascent seemed less adorable and precocious the more people learned about his home life. Plus, everyone in Hollywood has a bad experience working with Kit. The result of this was that Macaulay didn't do any film roles for 10 years. So he did what all normal kids do.
He went to high school.
But he did it for purely social reasons. He also got married at age 17 to Rachel Miner. He relished in the New York City counterculture lifestyle. He dyed his hair pink, smoked, drank, vandalized Rebel walls life. And parking meters.
It is exactly what I was talking about in the beginning. Now that he's free to do whatever he wants, he's gonna lash out, and so he did. Smoking, drinking, dyeing his hair.
He was trying to live the polar opposite experience of his childhood, and he had the money to treat everything like a hobby. The media watched his every move and criticized him. He was one of the early targets of the tabloid sensationalized media drama that famously targeted Britney Spears, Lindsay Lohan, and Paris Hilton. It was so blown out of proportion, Culkin says. I never did anything more than any upper-class, Upper West Side kid, you know, would. We weren't, like, all squatting in the corner shooting heroin. That quote was from 2001. A 21-year-old Macaulay Culkin thought he already made it through the toughest times in his life, and he didn't realize his darkest days were yet to come. In 2003, the 23-year-old decided it was time to return to the spotlight. Likely seeking a more mature image, he appeared in the biographical drama Party Monster, which is rated MA-15+. Mac only had one opportunity to make a grand return. Sadly, he blew it. Critics tore the film apart, with Party Monster receiving an awful 29% on Rotten Tomatoes, while struggling to earn over $1 million on a $5 million budget.
Hold on. In this film, based on a true story, Macaulay Culkin arrives on a Greyhound bus in New York City, desperate to leave his boring Midwestern past behind. After downtown club kid James St. James, Seth Green, and influential nightclub owner Peter Dylan Dermott, a fame-hungry Alec decides to throw the most controversial and over-the-top parties in the city. In just a few years, Alec's drug addiction and erratic behavior threaten to destroy the empire he's created. It's rated R, directed by Fenton Bailey, release date in theater 2003.
Wasn't looking for him anymore. Macaulay found himself in a complicated situation. He was too old to appeal to a younger audience, and the audience he garnered during his childhood had outgrown him. Desperate to bounce back from the disappointment, Macaulay booked a supporting role in the comedy film Saved. The controversial film was a moderate success. More importantly, Macaulay's performance received positive reviews, but just when he got a little bit of positive press, he was arrested for drug possession. Macaulay and a friend were pulled over for speeding on I-44 in Oklahoma City. The police found 17 grams of marijuana, 8 Xanax pills, and 16 Klonopin, none of which were prescribed to him. At the time, people jumped to conclusions, labeling Culkin as another child star gone wrong. However, Mac believed the arrest was totally blown out of proportion, suggesting, "I'm supposed to be a lot more effed up than I am. I took a certain amount of pride that I wasn't that cliche, so it was like, oh great, I gave a lot of people exactly what they wanted."
You know, everything that I do, for some reason, becomes this big crazy thing, you know, even though any normal person does it. Like, yeah, I'm a kid, I had a beer, you know, I smoked a joint. Big deal. You know what I'm saying? And it's not something I make a thing out of or anything like that.
Mac didn't think he had a problem. He didn't think it could get worse, but it did. He got divorced from his wife in 2002 and began a relationship with Mila Kunis. They kept their...
They dated? I thought she was always with Ashton Kutcher from, like, literally That 70s Show. Because I heard that he was her, what they call it, first kiss. My first kiss went a little like this.
Their personal lives very private. They both grew up as child stars and leaned on each other for emotional support. They didn't do press together and only rarely were photographed together, considering they dated for 7 years. After multiple failed attempts at coming back to the spotlight in early 2000s, he just stopped trying. Allegedly, Macaulay attempted to propose to Mila multiple times, in which she always said no. Then in 2008, he got floored with some tragic news. Macaulay Culkin's older sister Dakota was killed while walking home from Brennan's Bar in West Los Angeles. She was struck by a vehicle. The driver immediately tried to render aid. She was taken to the UCLA hospital with massive head trauma and passed away on December 10th. There aren't very many pictures of Dakota since she stayed out of the spotlight. This was devastating news for the family. But to make it worse, him and Mila broke up.
I had a horrible breakup. I had a horrible breakup. And I was
horrible
like,
in that it made you were very sad over it?
no, I fucked up. Like, I was an asshole in my 20s.
Oh, okay.
And I'll be the first to admit it. And that's kind of something that took me a long time to come.
Shut up, Meg. every interview, every article about her, that's all I see in the comments.
Shut up, Meg.
And be like, yeah, you know what? Yeah. I was a dick, and I accept it, and I own it now.
Yeah.
And it's fucked up what I did. It's fucked up what I did, and it's fucked up how I did it.
Mila kind of hints here that she may have cheated on Macaulay, or at least left him at his most vulnerable time after 7 years. After this, all of Mac's public photos were very concerning. He looked extremely skinny, unhealthy, and potentially using drugs. Extremely bold articles were published, stating that he was addicted to heroin and had only 6 months to live. They did not have any evidence to back up these claims, only that he had been arrested for drugs in the past. Plus, many years later, he said, "I wouldn't be the person I am today if I hadn't had drugs in my life at some point or another." Macaulay does admit this was the darkest time of his life. He couldn't eat all the foods he used to love eating. He couldn't sleep. He couldn't find any purpose in waking up in the morning. Then he got hit with another devastating blow when his lifelong friend Michael Jackson sadly passed away in 2009. The darkness loomed over his head for many years. He still just wanted to be left alone, but the media took any chance they could to post something about the child star who's cursed. He started a comedy musical group called Pizza Underground, where he did pizza-themed covers of songs.
It's like a cry for help. You doing pizza covers? This is a cry for help.
Nothing screams, "Leave me alone" and "I don't care" than putting a pizza on your face and playing
a
toy.
Is that an actual pizza or is this like a mask? If this is actual pizza, like, yeah, you like down bad.
But in 2013, he abruptly moved to Paris.
I thought nobody recognized me.
Yeah.
And what it was, "No, we recognize you, we just don't care."
Oh yeah, that's like, better. Is that better?
Where have you people been my whole life, kind of thing.
Mac was desperate to find some normalcy in his life, and he found it in France. He stayed there for 4 years, away from the cameras, away from the rumors, just walking around Paris with a baguette under his arm and blended in with everybody else. During his 4-year stint over there, his father said he doesn't even consider Macaulay his son anymore. And while that does seem like a very bold statement from his father, I'm sure Macaulay feels the same way. The thing that prompted his move back to the United States was meeting his now wife, Brenda Song. While on the set of Changeland in 2018, Macaulay met and began dating Brenda, best known for her appearance as London Tipton on The Suite Life of Zack and Cody. Bonding over being child stars, Mac thought it was too good to be true. He thought she would up and leave like other women in his life. But the couple would later get engaged and seemed happier than ever.
Aww.
They've been together ever since. Macaulay was so traumatized by his youth, he never thought he would have children of his own. But in 2021, Brenda gave birth to their son Dakota, who they named after Macaulay's sister. His relationship with Brenda brought some new life into him. He started multiple creative projects since meeting her, a comedy podcast called Bunny Ears, multiple television roles, and voiceover parts. He even had a big acting return in 2021 for the 10th season of American Horror Story, in which viewers praised his performance. His character, Mickey, quickly became a fan favorite. He remains relatively active on social media and has done a lot of public interviews and podcasts since meeting her. It seems like his wife and new family gave hope to the now 42-year-old. His father is in poor health, but Macaulay refuses to let his child meet
his father now? That's what you get, bro. That's what you get. You look horrible.
But with the abusive past, it's hard to blame Mac for this. Despite everything that's happened and constantly going in and out of retirement, Mac is grateful for the way his life went. Although he endured years of abuse, unfair public scrutiny, potential drug habits, and peaked at age 12, he is still grateful for the opportunities and money that came along with it. This life, he didn't choose for himself. He was born to achieve his father's dream. By the time he was 10, he had achieved everything his father never could. And since then, he's been living life on his own terms.
Yes, he seems like he's doing pretty well now. Got a life with Brenda Song, got a baby, got a podcast. Went back to acting, that went well. You're gonna be all right, Macaulay Culkin.